Third heat of the 800 metres, and Britain's Marilyn Okoro starting out in lane 7. She was a finalist last year. Got the best time this season of 1:59.53. Had a few problems, but getting back towards something like the shape that we know she can produce. Janet Jepkosgei, Kenya, in lane 2. That's, she sometimes has that name on her vest, but she is better known as Jepkosgei. Her full name, Janet Jepkosgei Kusieni. Tatiana Petliuk of the Ukraine alongside her. Alicia Montano of the United States. She starts in 4. And out on the outside there you see Marilyn Okoro. Katerina Kosteskaya of Russia will not want to make the mistakes that Yulia Rusanova made earlier on. Rusanova having an anxious wait to see if she's going to get through as a fastest loser. At the moment she's in the fastest loser position, quickest of the those who've not finished in the 4 automatic qualifying positions. Marilyn Okoro, Ewan Thomas, she often runs from the front.
Sometimes people argue too far from the front. If you want to look at a gutsy athlete, you're looking at one right now. I've seen her a few times this year go off a little bit too hard and pay for it at the end of the race, but she seems to be in good form now. 1:59 this year, she's going to have to run pretty well today to get through.
Geiger, Albania, Jepkosgei, Kenya, Petliuk, Ukraine, Montano, United States, Kosteskaya, Russia, Matsko, Kazakhstan, and Okoro for Great Britain. Matsko, the Kazakhstan athlete in lane 7, going well, and also a quick start from Jepkosgei, the Kenyan. Albanian, as we thought, in lane 1 at this stage, just allowing the athletes to go. Montano of the United States moving across with Jepkosgei, and those are the leaders as they go down the back straight for the first time. Here comes the Russian, Kosteskaya, taking closer order, moving up into third place as they come around the bend. Really hot here today. The athletes will be feeling this. It's the warmest day we've had. Around towards the straight now, and Jepkosgei, as she has done from the outset, is controlling the race from the inside. Then comes Montano of the United States. Okoro nicely placed in third at the moment. Kosteskaya up there as well. But this is good. She's got to stay in the first 4.
He's quick. He's 58.4. This is by far the fastest first lap we've seen so far. But Marilyn is running sensibly. She hasn't gone right to the front.
And that's Tatiana Petliuk, who's collapsed on the track. Take another look at that maybe later on. And down the back straight they go. Down the back straight. Jepkosgei is there, and also there is Okoro in that lead group of 4. And this is going absolutely according to plan for Okoro. She's going to make her way into the semi-finals as long as she can just stay out of trouble. She's in 4th place at the moment. Jepkosgei leads, then Montano, and then it's the Russian, Kosteskaya, and then Okoro in 4th. And it's a big gap back to those pursuing behind. And Okoro, oh, she's looking really good here, down the straight and moving through into 3rd place, right alongside Kosteskaya. Victory is going to be for Jepkosgei of Kenya, 2nd place Montano of the United States, 3rd Kosteskaya of Russia, and Marilyn Okoro in 4th place. The winning time, 1:59.37, so she'll be just outside 2 minutes. But she did well.
She did well, a very sensible qualification. In fact, when she looked up at the big screen as she was going around, the first 4 were clearly ahead of the rest of the field. She could have afforded to hang back, but as you see, massive daylight for the first 4 athletes. But Marilyn won't be aware of that. She'll be wanting to run hard to the line, but as you can see, those guys were clear. Fantastic qualification for her.
Yeah, qualification was made easier by the fact that Petliuk of the Ukraine fell on the first lap at 300 metres. She'd have been in the shake-up, unquestionably, and Marilyn, as a result of her absence, she had a much easier task. Let's take another look at this. What exactly happens? Look at it, Ewan.
There's nobody near her. Oh, she's pulled up. That's an injury. That's very unfortunate. You train all year round to peak for her championships, and she's come here. She's obviously injured. She's limping off the track, but nobody else's fault. Very sad scenes.
I really hope, for her sake, because she's taken away on a stretcher, I hope that's not the Achilles, because that could be bad news.
I can vouch for that. I've ruptured my Achilles before, and it feels like you've been basically shot in the bottom of the leg, and it's very, very painful. It's a serious injury, but we're looking at Marilyn here. really controlled. Really good running from the British girls so far this morning.
Jenny Meadows, if you're just joining us, already safely through as a heat winner, and she's been joined by Marilyn Okoro.
Well, Marilyn, you've got the pack of ice there. It is so hot down there, and we've just seen one of your competitors taken away on a stretcher. It's tough to qualify in conditions like this, isn't it?
Oh, wow. Like I was just saying to you, I've been here since 8:30 in the morning. It's just been getting hotter and hotter. Really tough conditions out here. And I had a really tough heat, so please, like, part one's done. Super, super nervous. Everyone at home will know, but it's always, you know, you've got to take the first round really seriously. So I knew it was fast, so I just wanted to just stick in there.
You got to the final in Berlin 2 years ago, so you're an experienced athlete. You know what it takes to get through the rounds. Does that make a difference, knowing that, having that in the bank?
Definitely. You know, you've been here before. It usually turns out to be hot, so it's just about using that experience and being as prepared as possible. UK have done a fantastic job with the medical team. You know, our Aviva camp in Ulsan prepared us brilliantly, so I was ready.
And were you aware of Jenny Meadows going through quite as comfortably?
Yeah, we watched. You know, that's, I think, why our heat was so fast, because we watched the first two in 2:01, so, yeah.
Knew you had a job to do, and you did it. Well done.
Thank you.
Thank you.